Now, is that okay?
Yeah, agriculture.
Okay. Friends, this is the second topic which I am covering now, agriculture. I don't want to confuse you with more agriculture schemes. I prepared a PPT in the examination point of view only. So I will discuss agriculture. What are the latest changes also I will discuss, which I am expecting from examination point of view. KCC, how many days we have to sanction KCC? 15 days. This is very, very important. Reminding home, but never they ask. Okay. So KCC branch powers are 15 days. Please remember. Other agriculture loans also up to 25,000, 15 days. Above 25,000, it is 30 days. Okay. But always they ask the question with regard to KCC only. Service area norms. Now in agriculture, they told up to 30 kilometers is the command area for all priority sector advances. This 30 kilometers, you have to remember, this is a new change in agriculture. Insurance up to 50,000 you can waive by taking NF-368. Waiving of agriculture loans, this is bills. Bills also you can waive up to 50,000. If it is a development loan up to 2 lakhs, you can waive. Only thing is within 15 days, you have to inspect and you have to make a certificate. That's all. Okay. Agriculture loans up to 50,000 you can waive bills, and development loans up to 2 lakhs. What is insurance? Generally, we take, I told you, insurance up to 50,000, we can waive. But whenever you are taking insurance for livestock, like poultry, poultry especially, you cannot take, because poultry, no insurance company will come forward to cover insurance. In that case, the bank says, we will take a corpus fund from the borrower on working capital limit, not on term loan. Whatever working capital you have financed, on that, we have to take some amount, some percentage of amount, and we will make an RD for 5 years. After 5 years, we will make that RD as a KD and you keep it with the loan paper. This is what bird insurance waiver, bird insurance, some scoring model they have to do, minimum score they have to acquire. After that, this corpus fund we will collect. How much corpus fund we have to collect with regard to bird insurance waiver? This, when I worked in Haryana, I used to do this. In Andhra and all, it is very less, this poultry loans and all. If you are doing poultry loan, livestock especially, no company will come for insurance. This rule will apply. Remember, whenever you go to poultry, there are three types of poultry we see. One is layer. Layer means it will give egg. This is a golden business in poultry. Then parent broiler. This is called hatchery. Parent broiler. And last one is commercial broiler. Commercial broiler means generally what we are eating, some small hen they will bring and 40, 45 days they will put it. And after that, they will sell. That is called broiler. So three type of things are there. Layer, hatchery, broiler. Technically they called, number one is layer, no confusion. Parent broiler means it's a hatchery, and commercial broiler means whatever we are eating, this, na, that is commercial broiler. So the what is the premium we have to collect? Layer is always safest business. If anybody does poultry advance, they know this. So that is the reason they kept only 6% on the working capital, 6% only. Hatchery, little bit risk is there. That's why they take 10%. Broiler is very, very risky business. That's why bank told 12% of the working capital we will take as a RD for them. This is with regard to bird insurance waiver. Valuation. In agriculture, if AEO or AEO promotee managers are working with you, they can up to loan amount of 30 lakhs, they themselves can give valuation. Of course, they themselves means they will not simply write the valuation. They will go to local sub-register office. They will take the values of the particular land and they can confirm. Why bank has done this? Because agriculturist, if you are giving for valuation, they have to pay some 5 to 10,000 rupees. That is the reason they told. For AEOs and AEO branch managers, they are very much experts in agriculture fields. They told up to 30 lakhs loan, KCC, KOD, any loan, poultry loan, they themselves can confirm the land value. But other managers like us, normal officers, normal clerk to become managers, we cannot give 30 lakhs, but we can give up to 20 lakhs. So AEO, AEO promoting managers up to 30 lakhs. And other managers up to 20 lakhs. This is loan amount. Please remember, even though you are valuing the property, if you are giving less than 30 lakhs loan, if you are a AEO, you can do valuation. You can give valuation. Okay, we can give. Then coming to periodicity of valuation with regard to agriculture. These are all policies this year have come. So that is the reason I am telling. Periodicity of valuation. If there is a structure, structure means some poultry shed is there. Okay, agriculture loan you are giving. Some poultry feed unit is there. That is also comes under agriculture. If structure is there, if some dairy unit is there, 3 years you have to do valuation. You know, structure, without any structure, some land property you have taken, vacant site or some agriculture land, up to 5 years you need not do again revaluation. So remember, periodicity of valuation. If there is a structure, 3 years. If there is no structure, vacant site, it is 5 years. Coming to margin norms, generally for agriculture up to 1.6 lakhs, we don't take any margin. Above 1.6 lakhs, we take 15 to 25% margin. This is very, very important thing. Again, I want to repeat, because recent circular, we have to remember this. But any exceptions are there? Yes. Exceptions are, if you are financing ALLHV, agriculture, light hypothecation vehicle, small vehicles, if your agriculture is asking, sir, for going to field, I need a vehicle. Heavy commercial vehicles also, like medium or heavy, the margin is only 10%. Please remember. If you are financing, generally we don't finance for purchase of agriculture land generally, but there is a scheme in our bank also for financing to purchase of land. In that case, the minimum margin is 20%. If you are financing medium heavy vehicles, second-hand vehicles, it is 25%. Normal, it is only 10%, no problem. And if you are financing to purchase of land, it is 20%. If you are financing to medium and heavy commercial vehicles, it is 25%. Exceptions, these are. Now, coming to the important scheme of KCC, Kisan Credit Card. How we assess the limit under KCC, we should know. Because he may ask any question from this. Because 2020 only, revised norms have come for KCC. Number one. Generally, KCC means we will give for crop cultivation purpose only, and even consumption, all term loan also we can add and we can finance under KCC. How we finance under KCC? Number one, the first is crop cultivation. That means agriculture comes to you, you have to give finance for crop cultivation purpose. So crop cultivation purpose, he may do sowing of wheat, paddy, anything. You know the how much expenditure he requires for that? You don't know. For that, government has taken care. You need not worry. One, DLTC, District Level Technical Committee. Please remember this word. It's a very important word. Why I am telling is, they will tell how much scale of finance can be given in KCC. Who is the deciding authority? Simple question. So you have to remember this. They will shortcut also. They may ask DLTC, or they may give you a full form, District Level Technical Committee. Even IIBF exams also, they are asking this question. This is very, very important. Who is dividing, who is fixing scale of finance? DLTC, District Level Technical Committee. What they will do is, they will tell in that area, they will survey, they will talk to agriculturist experts, and they will say, for paddy, for 1 acre, 50,000 required in my area. For wheat, it require 70,000. That is called a scale of finance for 1 acre. That is fixed by District Level Technical Committee. See, for example, now we will assess the limit. A borrower came for 2 acres of agriculture land. One KCC customer came to you, one farmer. 2 acres. If 2 acres is there and he is doing one crop as paddy and one crop as wheat. Crop is 50,000. Scale of finance. The DLTC has given to me chart. 70,000 for wheat. Total 1,20,000. Correct? For 1 year. 1,20,000 into 2 acres of land. Total is 2,40,000. This is called crop maintenance. Acreage of land into scale of finance. Multiplication is nothing but your crop maintenance. This is the important part we are financing. That is the first thing. After that, you have to add post-harvest household consumption. Even consumption, earlier we used to have a separate 15,000. Now that was removed in the new KCC guidelines. They told for post-harvest, once the crop is over, he has to take to some area to sell that crop. For that post-harvest, or even for consumption needs also, we can finance 10% of crop maintenance. Whatever you, for example, 2,40,000 we got, na? 70 plus 50, 1,20,000 paddy and wheat into 2 acres. If you got 2,40,000, on the 2,40,000, 10%, the 24,000 will be post-harvest household and consumption requirements. This is second one. Third one is repairs and maintenance expense of farm assets. He may be having tractor, he may be having some instruments which he uses for cultivation purpose. For that also, they told 20% on crop maintenance. Crop maintenance 2,40,000 na 20%. That means 48,000 will come here. This is how you have to finance for KCC. And the last but not the least is whatever insurance, Payas, Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, whatever insurance you are covering, that amount also customer will not give, farmer will not give. That amount, actual cost, whatever required from the farmer, that amount also you can add. And all these three, four items will be KCC finance. That's all. Am I clear? First is scale of finance. Second is 10% for post-harvest we will add. Then 20% for repairs and maintenance purpose we will add. And last, we will insurance, we will add actual expenses. And all these four total is your KCC first year limit. They may ask any question. I don't know how the examiner is going to ask. Examiner may ask you in KCC scale of finance, who is going to give you? District level technical committee. They may ask for KCC post harvest or consumption purpose, how much percentage on crop maintenance you can finance? 10%. They may ask for repairs and maintenance expenses, how much you can finance on crop maintenance? 20%. For insurance, they may ask actuals. All these four will be added and the limit will be fixed for KCC customer. This is very, very important thing you have to learn. For even if you become a branch manager and go also, these things you have to follow. Coming to this, after this crop maintenance, this is over. You have financed. For example, it is 2,40,000. Here 24,000. Here 48,000. Insurance some 5,000. Total you have added. He got 3 lakhs. For example, you imagine 3 lakhs. Remember, friends, after first year limit of 3 lakhs, every year you have to add 10% for 4 years. Sir, why, sir? Why to add 10%, sir? See, your salary is increasing, your DA is increasing, you are getting. Farmers also, every year, fertilizers, cost of labor, everything will be increased. By taking into these things into consideration, banks have been advised every year he will not come for enhancement. You also cannot enhancement. So what we will do is, out of these 3 lakhs, 10% next year you add 30,000. So second year limit will be 3,30,000. On 3,30,000, again 10%, 33,000. 3,30,000 plus 33,000. 3,63,000 for third year. Like that, 3 lakhs, 10%, 10%, 10%, 10%. 4 10% you have to add. And fifth year, whatever limit you are arriving, that will be the KCC limit for the customer. Please remember, they may ask how much percentage you will add every year to the KCC. There shall be 10% annual increase in working capital subject to satisfactory annual review. Okay, while fixing the limit, we will fix it for 5 years. First year we will arrive, how I told you. After that, 10, 10, 10, 10, 4 10s. Fifth year limit has come. That is the limit we will fix. What they're telling is, after next year, second year, once party comes, we will see whether he has paid the interest and all. If it is regular, we will have a review. NF-974 format we will use. We will do review and immediately we will increase that 30,000. For example, 3 lakhs we have sanctioned this year. Next year, liability is 3 lakhs. Party has paid interest. I will add 30,000 to the limit. So ALM 35 I will go and I will add 30,000. So the limit will become 3,30,000 from second year. Third year, whatever amount already I fixed, that amount also I will give. Like that, every year 10%. This is very, very important. How much annual increase can be permitted in KCC? 10%. Coming to documentation part, when you are giving 10%, first year is 3 lakhs. For example, 10, 10, 10, 4 years became 4 lakhs, for example. Documentation which we have to do, whether for 3 lakhs or 4 lakhs. Guidelines are very clear. The final year, fifth year, 4 lakhs, whatever is there, for that we will do documentation now. At the time of disbursement, we will do documentation for fifth year limit only. Please remember. And every year, based on the performance and satisfactory after review, we are releasing the limit. Okay, 30,000 next year 33,000, third year like that, we are going to release. This is one important point you have to remember. And always you remember, for KCC loans, the maximum loan limit is 50% of value of produce. What they want to tell is, for example, you are giving 50,000 as a scale of finance. That means 1 lakh should be the crop value. That is what. If crop value is 1 lakh, then only you can give 50,000. You are the deciding authority? No, you are not the deciding authority. That means district level technical committee, while fixing the limit, this part they will take care. If they are telling paddy you give 50,000 means, already they have taken care, crop will be 1 lakh rupees cost. Okay, that is called 50%. So crop loans, when you are giving KCC and all, what is the margin? 50%. Crop will be 50%, your finance will be 50,000. 1 lakh means 50,000. So that's why they told loan limit should not exceed 50% of the value of the produce. Coming to the repayment, this is also very important. If you are giving a short-term crops, paddy, wheat, all are short-term crops. Short-term crops will be liquidated within 12 months. That is the reason your KCC will be liquidated within 1 year. Please remember, if it is a long-term crop, only one crop I know, I am not a AEO, sugar, that sugar cane is a long-term crop. That means it will stretch for 18 months. It's a long crop. That is the reason for them, it is 18 months. So withdrawal for, so if you are financing for sugar cane, 18 months will be the repayment period for him. If you are financing for paddy and wheat, 12 months only, because it is short-term crop. Okay. Annual review, I already told you, NF 974 is the format. That for 5 years, na? First year, 10, 10, 10% you have added. So 4 years. So KCC is tenable or valid for 5 years. This question also, they may ask you, what is the validity period of KCC card? It is 5 years. Flexi KCC. The flexi KCC means marginal farmers. Marginal farmers, again, I'll tell you, 1 hectare land. Again, I'm repeating, this question may come. Small farmer, it is 2 hectares, 1 to 2 hectares. For marginal farmers, a flexible limit can be fixed by us from 10,000 to 50,000. Please remember, this is important. They may ask on flexi KCC, whom we can finance, marginal farmer. How much amount we can finance? 10,000 to 50,000. Other than KCC, now they told even term loan component also we can add under KCC. How much, sir? 3 times annual net income with a maximum of 5 lakhs under KCC. Working capital you have given for crop cultivation, that 5 years. After that, you can tell sublimit 2. This is called term loan component. This is also added here. How much you can give? 3 times net income of the farmer, but maximum is 5 lakhs. With this, KCC is almost over. Now KCC Tatkal, you remember, only they will ask what is the maximum amount, that's all. Tatkal, Krishi Mitra, credit card, both are 50,000 only. Remember this point, that's all. Never they ask any other question from this. But I will tell you, Kisan Tatkal is Tatkal, loan itself is Tatkal like train ticket. For post-harvest expenses only they give, okay? So minimum is 1,000, maximum 50,000 they can take. Okay, 3 to 5 years installment. You need, I don't think you need, even I don't remember this. I never got this question, but this question I got. Kisan Tatkal, what is the maximum amount we can finance? 50,000. Krishi Mitra credit card. Krishi Mitra, Mitra means friendly. We are friendly with Kisan credit cards. How much they told is 50,000 you can finance for these or lessees, sharecropper. They are poor farmers, small farmers. That's why they told 50,000. Always, I told you that produce value will be 50%. Any KCC you are giving, if you are sanctioning 50,000, security value should be 1 lakh because 50% margin. Okay, tenability is 3 years with regard to this one. Kisan OD. Friends, maybe I may tell about Kisan OD, but I never seen any question on Kisan OD. Only once, some 4 or 5 years back, I have seen one question. But for knowledge purpose, or maybe this time if examiner comes, you should answer. Once you give KCC, next 1 year, you cannot give KOD. Please remember, if you are a branch manager, you cannot sanction KOD till 1 year KCC is satisfied. But exception is there. We can take higher authority permission like circle head and we can do it. But generally, normal cases, we cannot do. After KCC, 1 year satisfactory only, we can finance under KOD. And one more thing. You have already financed under KCC for crop cultivation. On KOD, what you will give them? Already you have financed. Na? Again, KOD also, if you give for crop cultivation, it's a double finance. That is the reason this is not for the purpose of crop production. This is very, very important. KVOD is not for crop cultivation. Already you have given KCC. So this is not for, then what for you are giving? We are giving for repairs. We are giving for replacement of animals. We can give finance for machinery, land development expenses, any private debts he wants to clear, any non-farm sector, consumption needs. These are the purposes only we generally finance under KOD, not for crop cultivation. Please remember, even if you work as a branch manager, you should not write crop cultivation for KOD. Already you're financed under KCC. Other purposes only you have to add. Those are the purposes I've discussed. The KOD, the minimum amount is 1 lakh. 50,000 you cannot sanction under KOD. That means I feel personally minimum 1 acre land is required to sanction under KOD, because they say 1 lakh per acre. You see here, this ceiling is there. That's why I remember. So minimum 1 acre is there. Then only you can finance KOD. Okay. What is the, how much amount we can finance under KOD? See, normally KOD will be sanctioned 3 times gross annual income of the farmer with a maximum 7.5 lakhs. Please remember. But wherever recovery is more than 90%, there we can finance maximum 4 times gross annual income with maximum 12.5 lakhs. Generally, this will be permitted by circle heads. Then only we can finance. Otherwise, generally finance this only. 3 times gross annual income, maximum 7.5 lakhs. And please remember, 1 lakh per acre. That's all. That means to finance 7.5 lakhs, a borrower should have minimum 7.5 acre of land. Then only you can finance 7.5 lakhs, because 1 lakh per acre. But wherever 90% recovery, you can finance more, 1.50 lakhs per acre. This is what you have to remember. Less than 90% recovery, normal KOD, 3 times 7.5 lakh, 1 lakh per acre. If it is more than 90% recovery, 4 times gross annual income, 12.5 lakhs, you can maximum you can finance, and 1.5 lakhs per acre. Okay. And coming to KOD for private debts, I told you for clearing of private debts also, you give the maximum we can give is 2 lakhs. Okay, folio charges. Every 40 lines, every 40 lines in OCC account, current account, we call it as folio. And for 40 lines, we charge 100 rupees. And quarterly, along with interest, this amount will be charged to the customer. Tenability, KOD is tenable for 3 years. KCC is tenable for 5 years. KOD is tenable for 3 years. Next loan, over. KCC over, KOD over. Now I came to produce loan. First, you understand what is a produce loan. Produce loan means farmer, once the crop cultivation is over after 1 year, he will get the crop on his hand. Sometimes he cannot sell immediately. Then what he will do, it should not be destroyed. It's a perishable item. So he will keep, he will go to some warehouse. He will keep there, and that warehouse fellow will give one warehouse receipt. Yes, this farmer has deposited some 10 bags of rice. That warehouse receipt he will have. If that farmer wants to take some finance against that warehouse receipt, that is called produce loan. How much amount we can finance for produce loan? 50 lakhs. If you remember, while telling my priority class, I told you for classifying a produce loan under priority, the maximum loan we can sanction is 50 lakhs and the repayment period is 12 months. Both these lines you have to remember for priority. Here also same thing it is coming, you can observe. Even produce loan, if bank is giving also, bank says repayment maximum 12 months only, maximum. Okay. Then produce loan 50 lakhs you can give to farmer, and branch can sanction only up to 10 lakhs. About 10 lakhs only your ROCO can sanction. Okay. And produce loan, how much amount? Yes, brought the warehouse. How much we can? 75% of the assessed value we will finance. Even on that, they say the minimum support price given by central government or current market price or the negotiable warehouse receipt what the farmer has brought. Out of this, whichever is least, for example, warehouse receipt says, for example, 1 bag he has kept. 1 bag cost is 10,000. Market price is 8,000. Minimum support price government is giving 7,000. Which one is least, sir? Minimum support price. On that 7,000, 75% we will finance. So minimum support price, current market price, and negotiable warehouse receipt what he brought. All these three you have to see which one is least, on that 75% you can finance under produce loans. This is with regard to produce loan. Farm machinery loans means tractors. If you are giving tractors, power tillers, 2-3 important points, examination point of view, we have to remember with regard to tractor. The important points are, if you are giving a tractor loan, the borrower should have minimum 8 acres irrigated land, double. Always in the agriculture, double only. Irrigated is 8 means, unirrigated 16, double. In every case, it will be like this only. So if you remember, for tractor loan, 8 acres land is required from the borrower. If you give a tractor for 1 acre fellow, what he will do? He cannot 1 acre, in 1 acre, where he will rotate the tractor? It is very difficult. That is the reason they told minimum 8 acres irrigated land or 16 acres dry land is required for a farmer to take a tractor loan from you. And the important point, sir, 8 acres he has taken tractor, where he is running? So running hours also they have given. If tractor usage should be minimum 1200 to 14 hours, that means he can hire to somebody also. But minimum 600 in his own land. These 8 acres, whatever he has already availing, more than 8 acres, there he has to run 600 hours. Other than that, he can hire to somebody also, no problem. But the maximum usage is, minimum usage is 1200 to 14 hours. This is with regard to tractor loan. Okay, somebody will come, sir, I want small tractor, 30 HP only I want. For that, guidelines are different. What are the guidelines? If you are financing to farmers for smaller tractor means 30 HP. This may be more HP will be there for normal tractors. Here 8 acres, this 6 acres. Irrigated land 6 acres, automatically dry land will be double, 12 acres. Remember 8 acres for tractor, small tractor 6 acres, that's all. If it is irrigated, unirrigated, if you ask, double it. We can finance for brand new 30 HP tractor, accessories and implements also. If a small tractor, automatically hours will be less. This is a big tractor, 1200 to 1400. Here they are telling at least 1000 to 1200 working hours, including minimum 500 hours in his own farm. That's all. Here 12 to 400, 600. Here 1000 to 1200 and 500 in his own land. What is the amount we can finance under small tractor? Maximum 3.5 lakhs we can finance for small tractor. And additional 50,000 also we can finance for accessories and implements. Okay, total 4 lakhs we can finance for small tractor. 3.5 lakh for tractor and additional accessories and all we can finance 50,000. And repayment can be considered up to 7 to 9 years. That's all. These are the important points from, if I go on reading the circular, you cannot consume also. So examination point of view, these questions are only coming. So I have taken the important points. Minimum, you try to remember these important points. Dairy loans. Whenever you are financing a dairy, the life of the buffalo, you should know. Buffalo is giving 5 to 7 lactations. Lactations means they're delivering a baby, means they will give milk. So 5 to 7 lactations a buffalo will do. Cow is having 10 lactations. The lifetime of the cow is more comparing to buffalo. So if it is 5, to which extent? If 7 lactations means gone, then the buffalo will be dry buffalo. They will not get any milk. So the bank says up to 3rd lactation you can finance. Okay, up to 3rd lactation we can finance. Coming to a definition called high yield milch animal means, what is high yield? If any animal is giving 5 liters milk per day, we call it as high yield milch cattle. But for last 4 years, I never seen any question on this topic. But dairy, we should remember. That's why I told. Coming to Matya Suraksha, Matya Parirakshana, Matya Samriddhi. Matsya means in Hindi, it is fish. So only if you are financing to fisherman, fisherwoman, only this scheme will come. And for your information, I don't want to touch this scheme. Only for academic purpose, or if at all examiner comes, you have to answer. Only 2 things you have to remember. First is Suraksha, Pariraksha. How I remember Suraksha and Pariraksha? Suraksha, if you are financing to men, always I feel that women, physically men are better than women. So Suraksha, I remember, for remembering, I'm telling, not to comment anybody. For Suraksha, when you are financing, men will come into picture. If you are financing to men, For repairs of own boats, fishermen, Suraksha will be applicable. For Pariraksha means, Pariniti Chopra name I will always remember. Pariraksha means it's a woman. See, in the examination, Suraksha, Pariraksha question comes means you will confuse. You have to keep some logic. Why I also will tell you. Suraksha, for a fisherman, they will give minimum 10,000, maximum 1 lakh. Remember this amount. For men is more amount, 10,000, 1 lakh. And Pariraksha, Pariniti Chopra means women, they will give 50% of the amount. Automatically 10,000 will become 5,000, 1 lakh will become 50,000. This is how you have to remember Suraksha and Pariraksha. Matya Suraksha, Matya Pariraksha. Repayment, they told 35 months repaid in and 24 equal installments. If you could able to remember, you remember, otherwise you will do it. But this amount you should not forget. Suraksha, giving finance to men fishermen, safe hands, 10,000, 1 lakh. Pariraksha, Pariniti Chopra, woman fisherman, we are fine. Woman fisherwoman, we are giving. Amount is 50%. Okay, 50,000 and 5,000. 10,000 is 5,000. 1 lakh will become 50,000. 35 months is the repayment period. Samriddhi, last scheme. Suraksha, Pariraksha, we got some technical words. Samriddhi is a self-help group we will finance. What this self-help group will do? They will be a group they will form. With that group, they will do fish vending, drying, salting, feed, the net making, all these things they will do. Only thing is finance, we can do maximum 50,000 per member and maximum amount is 10 lakhs per group. That's all. Okay. This is with regard to Samriddhi. 10,000, 1 lakh, Suraksha, men. Pariniti Chopra, Pariraksha, 5,000 and 50,000. Samriddhi, it is a SHG group account we are financing for doing. Group will form and group will create some feed production, manure, net making, all these things they will do. For that, 50,000 per member we will go, maximum 10 lakhs. And limit will be for 5 years with monthly interest. Agri clinic and agri business center. Only two important things you have to remember. What is agri clinic? What is agri business? He may ask by telling some definition and ask, what is this? So that is the reason. Simple, you remember, agri clinic, agriculture clinic. What agriculture clinic? Farmer go to hospital, then only agri clinic, right? But they told this clinic means here one expert will be sitting. He will give advice to the farmer. Agri clinic means a agriculture graduate will sit in agri clinic. He will give suggestions. Yeah, this year you do paddy. This year you do this crop you put this fertilizer you put, you will get more production. So expert advice will be given from agri clinic. You can see to provide expert advice service to farmers on technology, cropping pattern, pesticides, diseases, market trend, all these things. Technical information, this doctor will give information to agriculturist. Coming to agri business center, nothing. Agriculturist wants some farm equipments on hire, like tractor, all these things. That will be provided by agri-business centers. So who will form this agri-clinic and agri-business is the question now. Individuals can form joint partnership company. Anybody can do. But only thing is agriculture graduate should be available in that particular group. Okay. 5 eligible candidates can apply this agri-clinic and agri-business center. And they can start this agri clinic or agri business. Please remember, minimum one person should be on that 5 people, 5 grouply they will do that. In that 5 persons who are giving this clinic advisor or business centers, one should be management graduate or account graduate. Please remember, he should be a graduate. Then only they can form this group. 20 lakhs per graduate they will give and 100 lakhs per group. The maximum amount under agri clinic and agri business is 20 lakhs per graduate, because 5 members are there, 5 into 20, 100 lakhs we can finance. And because it's an agri clinic and agri business center, margin up to 5 lakhs nil, above 5 lakhs, 50 into 25%. With this, almost many normal agriculture important schemes I have covered. Now, little bit agriculture, some questions I'm expecting. Those questions in a short way, I will tell you for 5 minutes. Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. What is the premium we have to pay? Rabi, 1.5% we have to pay. Kharif, 2%. Commercial crop, 5%. Question may come from anywhere. They may ask Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, what is the percentage of premium for Rabi crop, Kharif crop or commercial crop? Commercial crops always costly, so 5% we will give. Indemnity. When we are covering under Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, we have to give indemnity to the farmer that if anything happens to your farm because of rain, flood, drought, whatever it may be, how much amount we will give. After the government will decide, whatever they decide, if it is high, we will give 70%. If it is moderate, we will give 80% indemnity. If it is low, we give 90% of indemnity to the farmer. This is with regard to Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. This is the very, very important circular. I'm expecting question on this. Margin and security norms with regard to agriculture. Always they will try to ask this question. Just now I told you, for agriculture, margin up to 1.6 lakhs nil. Above 1.6 lakhs, 15 to 25%. Security up to 1.6 lakhs. No security, I don't say. Hypothecation of crops, assets created. Whatever you are giving finance, that is only a security. No collateral security you will get. For above 1.6 lakhs loans, you can get. But up to 1.6, you cannot ask any collateral security. Please remember, it is earlier it is 2 lakhs. Now it is modified to 1.60 lakhs. This is a very, very important question for me. For loans above 1.6 lakhs, if you are financing, yes. Hypothecation of crops, anyway, when we are financing, that also prime security is a prime security. Mortgage of landed property also you can take. Okay. In case charge creation is done manually, shall be created in CRESPA of loans above 1 point. If charge creation is possible to do in online or manually, you can do above 1.6. Regarding KCC, I have seen one important point. Generally, KCC validity is 5 years. We have discussed. They are telling after 5 years of tenability, once the sanction is over, 5 years is over. At the end of the 5th year, we have to close the KCC and we have to give fresh sanction and these guidelines to be followed. Okay. This is with regard to security and margin. Question may come from here. I am sure. Definitely one will get. I don't know which cadre they will get. 1.6 is the key answer for this. But this also you remember. Above 1.6, what is the margin means? 15 to 25%. This also you remember. That's all. Okay. Policy on sanction, monitoring and recovery of gold loans. This is a recent circular with regard to this. We have given LTV up to 90% for agri gold loans and all. Now Reserve Bank of India is telling, if the LTV ratio is falling below, if you have fixed 90% LTV, it is falling 99%, 98%, 97%, somewhere you have to trigger. So Reserve Bank of India told to all commercial banks, if you are giving, you have already given a loan and you have stipulated some LTV, loan to value ratio. Loan to value means 100 rupees security, 90 lakhs loan you have given. See, if it is increasing 91, 92 means your LTV is coming down. So Reserve Bank of India is telling, if LTV ratio is 3% lower than the stipulated RD, 90% you have done, it became 3% more. Then immediately you have to trigger. Trigger means you have to start follow up with the borrower. If he is not repaying, you are supposed to auction the gold also. This is what you have to do. So they say 3%, 4% are important. Please remember, if 3% is there, it is only for non-agriculture purpose. That means 90% if you give, up to 93% you can wait. No problem. But if you are giving for agriculture, it is 4%. So 4% gap we will aid. 190 is there. 100 is the security. 90 is the LTV ratio. If it goes more than 3%, we will wait. But more than 3%, we cannot wait for non-agriculture borrowers. Agriculture borrowers, up to 4%, we can keep calm. But if it is more than 4%, we should work on it. We should start recovering our amount. How to recover? Once the trigger LTV is breached, that means more than 4% LTV bad gaya. More than 3% for non-crop purpose, LTV bad gaya. Then what you have to do is, immediately you have to send a notice. If LTV is triggered, what RBI told, 3%, 4% more ho gaya. Then you have to do LTV first notice, you have to immediately. Once it is crossed 4% for agriculturist, send a notice. After that, you give 15 days time and again you have to give notice 2. 15 days from notice 1. First notice we give today. After that 15 days, we will go give for second notice. 30 days from notice, another 15 days. 30 days from notice one from here. 30 days auction come reminder notice we will send. See, already your LTV is more than 4%. We have waited for 1 month. If you are not paying, we are going to auction your gold. This is what Reserve Bank of India told to banks. Okay. Now, how to do the auction? They are telling the auction should be completed 45 days for agriculture gold loans, 30 days for non-agriculture loans. Please remember, agriculture always they give more comfort. So non-agriculture, they say 30 days for agriculture, they take 45 days. That auction, everything should be completed, sell the gold and take the amount. Okay. But you have to give notice to the borrower. So they say bank should put in a system, declare every fourth Friday. Please remember this date. Every fourth Friday, we have to do this monthly auction of sale of gold ornaments to realize the recovery dues. Every fourth Friday, we will declare that we are going to auction the gold. So branch to put a system to declare every fourth Friday of the month for conducting monthly auction for sale of gold ornaments to realize and recover the dues of NPA. But it need not be NPA. 94% means it need not be NPA. It is 4% more LTV. It cannot be NPA. Even in that case also, we can recover. So we have to remember 4% for agriculture triggering, 3% for non-agriculture purpose, and loan to be closed for normal purpose, normal loans, gold loans, non-agriculture purpose, 30 days. For agriculture purpose, it is 45 days. When you are going to auction, every month, fourth Friday, you are going to auction. Once you have gone to auction, but you could not able to sell the gold, 10% of the reserve price. See, for example, one gold I am to sell. It is a gold worth of 100 rupees. Appraiser told it will go for 90 rupees. I have kept for 90. Nobody is taking. 10% I can reduce. Who can reduce? Your RO AGM can reduce. Regional head is power to reduce 10%. First auction 90 rupees I cannot sell. So 9 rupees he can reduce and he can sell. 81 rupees he can keep a reserve price. Below that, if you want to go 80 rupees, 79 rupees, only circle head has to permit. Above 10% surplus, your RO head can permit. This is gold loan. These are the latest circulars. I'm expecting some questions. So that is the reason I'm telling you. Gold loan outstanding balance one report they have kept. The report number is 271004. If they ask report number, we cannot answer. That is the reason I have given that report. The important point is when we have to take gold balancing. Gold balancing every last Friday, all quarters, March, June, September, December, we have to take, along with that last working day of March for balance sheet purpose. This is the balancing we have to take for gold loans. Last Friday of March, June, September, December. If you see this fifth one, last working day of March, automatically you will come to know last Friday also we have to take. That means in March, we have to take last Friday also, last working day also for balance sheet purpose. Remaining all quarters, we take on last Friday only. Even RBI also, RBI means risk-based internal audit also. We generally check these gold packets. Self-help groups linkage month. Please remember, now we are in November almost. Please self-help group with this month, you remember. After that, every quarter, they made 1 month. Every quarter, for example, April to June, 1 quarter. 1 month they made as a SHG credit linkage month. They may ask any question, SHG credit linkage month, which month we have to perform. So this month, if you remember November, automatically you will get November plus 3, December, January, February. February will be next SHG credit month. After that, 3, May, then June, July, August, then September, October, November. Every year, every quarter, 1 month only they will do. That 1 month, if you remember November, automatically add 3 months, you will get this answer. You need not remember. Only one thing you have to remember, SHG month is November. For October to December, November is the month. Or else you can remember in between months they are doing. Every quarter in between month they are doing. April to June, May. July to September, August. So in between months they are doing. Okay. This is how you have to remember. Coming to jewel appraisers, one recent circular has come. generally one panel will be there at jewel appraisers at RO. Whatever they told gold loan wing, they told is 1:10 ratio we have to keep people. That means one branch, one gold appraiser will take care of 10 branches. After that, one extra appraiser will be available for meeting the contingencies. But in some places, we are not finding more gold appraisers. So that is the reason. South, we have lot of gold loan. Correct? Na? Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh. You can see these names. Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Union Territory of Pondicherry. We are financing more gold loans. Their bank doesn't want to take risk. They told 1:10 we will maintain. Other than these states, they have relaxed to 1:20. One gold appraiser for 20 branches. 1:20 only other than these states. Please remember, other than these states. Remaining all states you can do. If you are in Karnal, Haryana, yes, 1:20 can be permitted. But in Andhra Pradesh, it cannot be permitted. Karnataka, it cannot. Because southern states are strong in gold loan. That's why bank doesn't want to relax this 1:20. Pradhan Mantri, this Yojanas and all, whenever you are paying money to the government, payment gateway charges we have to pay. For that, bank has issued one circular. We have to take 5% payment gateway charges. Even IRCTC ticket you book also, you pay payment gateway charges. 5% plus 18% GST, total will be 5.90. Is in recent circular, you may ask a question, how much payment gateway charges bank has to pay when you are paying service charges for PMFBY, this RW, BCIS schemes. These are all crop insurance schemes. Okay, payment gateway charges is 5 rupees plus GST. Last 2-3 minutes, I'm concluding. This is launching of central sector interest subvention scheme for financing agriculture infrastructure fund of Ministry of Agriculture, Cooperation of Farmers, Welfare Government of India. In one line, I will tell you, agriculturist will do crop cultivation, right? After crop cultivation, he needs a good infrastructure, right? To send that particular goods through some area. For example, I am doing in some rural area. I need some infrastructure, correct? Otherwise, how I can send my agriculture produce to city? So for that infrastructure facilities, government wants to give some funds for development of infrastructure, for infrastructure for farmers, so that they can send that produce to the nearby place. This is the concept. For that, the implementation period is this year they have started, 10 years they have kept. Till 2030, this limitation period is there. In that, government of India want to invest 1 lakh crore. I don't know, 3 to 4, they may ask this question. How much for infrastructure, for agriculture, how much fund government of India want to invest? 1 lakh crore. And period is 10 years. And interest subvention, if anybody is doing these infrastructural projects, they tell 3% of loan up to 2 crores for a period of 7 years will be given. If anybody is doing this infrastructure, these roads and all, that person, if we are financing, they are telling for that projects, we can give 3% loan up to 2 crore for a period of 7 years only. And CGTMSE coverage also will be given for those loans up to 2 crore. Okay, this is with regard to this particular fund. Empanelment of agriculture consultants, 477/20. So IBPS, I may go in that circular. So that is the reason I have written. Some panel of agriculture consultants we are empaneling for sourcing agriculture proposals. They will source some agriculture proposals. That is called PACS, empanelment of agriculture consultants. They will bring some proposals to branches. For them, we have to pay some commission. What is that commission? 0.10% of loan amount with a maximum of 50,000 we have to pay. PAYAS, personal accidental insurance scheme. The most important question as per PAYAS is, who is the insurance agency for that? Bajaj Allianz, please remember. Even for Syndicate Bank also, Canara Bank also, Bajaj Allianz General Insurance is taking care of PAYAS. PAYAS always, they ask, what is the premium? The PAYAS premium is 25 rupees. Bank will pay 70 rupees, 8 rupees farmer will pay, which is included GST. Okay, 25 rupees is a premium. And PAYAS, when you are covering, what is the benefit to the farmer? personal accident. This is accidental insurance, please remember. That's why it is 25 rupees. If death of the borrower happens within 12 months from the accident, it's accidental insurance. Normal death, nothing will be paid. If it is accident only, we will get. Former will get. Death due to the accident, 1,50,000. Death means straight away 150 they will give. Permanent total disability or two limbs and two eyes and or one limb and one eye. That means multiple problem comes means total disabled. He was on bedridden or he got two limbs gone or two eyes gone or one limb and one eye. Both here also two, one limb and one. Then we have to pay 1,87,500 is the coverage. If he got, if he lost only one limb and one eye, then 75,000 only they will finance. This is a risk coverage. Generally, they never ask a risk coverage, but remember this sum assured amount is 150 and this amount minimum you have to remember. If you could able to remember, remember all the items, but 25 rupees is very much important. Bajaj Allianz is important. Bank share, sometimes they will ask in Payas, what is a bank share or farmer share? So we should know the shares also 17 plus 8. And these payas will be covered up to the age of 70 years. This is very important. And if it is a joint account, if you are giving, number one will be covered. If he is a partnership firm, managing partner or partners who is having maximum share can be covered. If it is a, accounts of companies cannot be covered. It is excluded from coverage. Okay. HUF account, Karta will be covered. This is a very important point. Now, recently, finance minister told 2.5 crore farmers, we have to give KCC loan. This 2.5 crore farmer, please remember, in the examination, if they ask, what is the recently honorable finance minister announced to cover how many farmers from the banking system? 2.5 crore. And the next important is sometimes they will ask, what is Kharif and what is Rabi? The season period, you have to remember. Kharif means June to September. Rabi means November to May. Even if you search Google also, it will not give proper answer. This Kharif and reason, recently one circular has come, it has very clearly given. Kharif means June to September, Ravi means November to May. This is my last slide. Waiver of service charges for KCC. Please remember, small and marginal farmer. Marginal farmer, 1 hectare land. Small farmer, 1 to 2 hectare land. If you are financing them up to 3 lakhs, no charges. Okay, over. Agriculture Innovation Center. Whenever any big projects are coming, we will give to Agriculture Innovation Center for appraisal of that proposal. You see TFOs, technical field officers. When I talk trade policy, I think Chandrasekhar Reddy sir might have told you. This is for agriculture, so I'm telling on agriculture. Latest circular, I am expecting question on here. Agriculture Innovation Center is a center located in Bangalore. What they will do is, if any big proposal, if you come finding in agriculture, you have to send the proposal to them. They will appraise the proposal, whether it is technically feasible or not, economically viable or not. Once they say, yes, this proposal can be taken up by the bank, then only we can take it up for sanction. Before sanction, AIC will appraise the proposal. Okay. The name also you have to remember for agriculture, Agriculture Innovation Center will do. If a new project, if the amount is 150 lakhs and above, it will go for AIC for appraisal. Remember, if he's an existing customer already enjoying some agriculture limits with you, then the amount is 300 lakhs. Exist new customer, na, small amount they kept. Existing customer, okay, we will go up to more exposure, 3 crores. So 150 lakhs, 300 lakhs. You have to remember 150 lakhs for new customers. New customer always they keep low amount. Existing customer means already dealings are satisfactory. So amount was increased to 3 crores. So 1.5 crore and 300 lakhs. And the last is sick units. If AIC, these are normal units. This is good units. No problem. If sick unit is going to be conducted by AIC, then the amount is 100 lakhs and above. With this, I'm concluding my agriculture class. Maybe I took some little bit more time. Okay, 9:21. So thank you, friends. Tomorrow I will try to cover. If I think tomorrow after talking to sir, I will tell you, maybe I will take class on balance sheet analysis so that you can answer any question. Sir, I will conclude my session.
Tomorrow we can have a session.
Okay, sir.
Tomorrow, there are some requests to start at 8 o'clock because some people are not able to reach early.
Okay, sir. Okay,
no problem. So we will have at 8 o'clock. Is it okay?
Okay. 1 hour I will take class on balance sheet. I will try to make you understand the conceptual understanding so that let the problem, any examiner give you any type of problem on balance sheet, you people could able to answer. And 30 minutes, I will try to solve how the DSCR ratio should be calculated, how NWC to be calculated, how that current ratio to be calculated. Only the